Yaba, there is news and there is gist. Hey, Ghana for Ghana is very hot these days. Very, very hot. Even me, I can feel the heat from here. I don't know if you can feel it. Hey guys, today's news dear, is hot. It's super, super hot. Hello gist partners. News about. There is news and there is this. Hey, Ghana for, as I said before, Ghana is super, super hot. I don't know if you are feeling the heat or I don't know, but me here, I can feel it. Ghana is just so, so hot. You ask me, what do you mean? Don't worry. That is why you have to listen to this news. Anyway, before we jump right into the news, if you know you're not following my other channel, Sandals Joyful Space, hey, you are missing out on a lot of fun. Please do check it out. Thank you very much. Please watch this video till the end because you don't want to miss any part of this gist. You want to hear the details. Anyway, no time to talk much. Let's just jump right into the news as it is hot. Danish Prime Minister calls on Akufo-Addo. Let me take it again. You didn't hear, eh? Danish Prime Minister calls on Akufo-Addo. Hey, did you hear that? Eh? They say what? Danish Prime Minister calls on what? Akufo-Addo. Have they called you? Is your phone ringing? Have you picked? Are they calling you? Anyway, let's just continue. Prime Minister of Denmark Mette Frederiksen has paid a courtesy call on President Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo Wednesday, November 24, 2021. The leaders discussed the strengthening of the Denmark and Ghana bilateral ties and welcomed the opportunity for further cooperation on a range of issues. I don't know if you got it. They are discussing what? They want to strengthen what? What are they strengthening? We see you. Let's continue. The leaders agreed on the importance of richer economies stepping up to help the developing world grow in a clean and sustainable way. The Prime Minister expressed her hope that Denmark could work more with Ghana on various levels, including water and sanitation. Mette Frederiksen is on a two-day official visit to Ghana from Wednesday, November 24th to Thursday, November 25th, 2021, the Danish Embassy in Accra has said. A statement issued by the Danish Embassy said her visit would mark the 60-year anniversary of diplomatic relations between Denmark and Ghana. He said the opposition leader from the Liberal Party of Denmark, Jacob Ellemann-Jensen, would join the delegation. Ms. Frederiksen, after a meeting with President Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, was expected to meet Cecilia Abenadapa, Minister for Sanitation and Water Resources. During the visit, Ms. Frederiksen will visit the Frigate Esbensnier, which has been deployed to the Gulf of Guinea until April 2022. The Danish contribution is improving maritime security and deterring piracy in the area, where 30 to 40 Danish-operated ships are present on a daily basis, it said. The Prime Minister would also meet with Danish companies, Ghanaian CSOs, and explore the extensive water cooperation between Denmark and Ghana, the statement added. Ms. Frederiksen is also visiting Tema the same day in connection with the city cooperation between Tema and Aarhus in Denmark. Ahead of her visit, Ms. Frederiksen said she looked forward to exploring Danish contributions to fight against piracy in the Gulf of Guinea. Denmark is one of the primary seafaring nations in the world, and as such, we have a special interest in protecting the global maritime trade. At the same time, the visit is important, marking the strong relationship between Ghana and Denmark. After decades of development aid, our partnership is now developing in new directions, she said. She was appointed Prime Minister on June 27, 2019, after the Social Democrat leader led her party back to power in June 2019 in general election. Then, 41, she became the country's youngest Prime Minister. She took over the party leadership in 2015 and when her predecessor and Denmark's first woman Prime Minister, Eli Thorning-Schmidt, lost power. Ghana for, that's the news though. As I heard it, I say, quick, I have to bring it to my people, to my gist partners. Like guys, Denmark has come to Ghana. They have seen that this is the happening place. Where else should I be if not the happening place? They talked about how they want to strengthen the bond between Ghana and Denmark, how they want to improve maritime security, how they want to explore the extensive water cooperation between Denmark and Ghana, and a lot more. They were just talking and talking and talking, and I'm just like, We are listening. We are listening. Guys, it is not a coincidence. It is not just happening. There is something going on. Ghana is on the right track. Ghana is really on the right track. Because this is not the first time we are hearing a country say we want to tighten our bonds with Ghana. Guys, I'm excited about the news. Like, I'm excited. I don't know about you, but I'm very excited about this news. Because this is just putting Ghana more on the map. More people will begin to hear the name Ghana. If you have not heard of Ghana before, actually, you go hear them this time. You go what? You go hear them this time. They are saying that other countries are coming to Ghana. They are saying, what is in that Ghana? Let us also go and visit. Let us also go and see what is happening there. They are not putting on the story to make it sweet. They are here to tighten the bond between Denmark and Ghana. They are here to, you know, tighten the relationship, strengthen the bond, do this, do that. We know, we already know, we already know. You have heard the gist. You have heard it. You heard that Ghana is the happening place. Ghana is the new hot cake. Ghana, the hot well. You people have heard and you have come in. And I'm sure that you guys are impressed. Yeah. You are impressed. You are impressed. Me too, that I'm here. I'm impressed. I'm proud. I'm happy. Hey. I'm very, very happy. Oh. The other time it was Germany, Dubai, Japan, Hungary. Even Serbian is part. Hey, you don't know share. You don't know what is going on. It will shock you. These days, Ghana not they grill. Ghana, they give shock. It they give shock well. Guy, when I heard this news, I was excited. I was like, yes, you guys should keep coming. You guys should be coming. Because one thing I know is that Nana Akufo-Addo is smart. As they are coming, he knows that it too go benefit. Ghana too for benefit for all this they are coming and speaking all this their BB grammar. Ghana too for benefit for all this their proposals and talk here, talk there, talk there. Yes, they are coming to benefit. They're not coming to just visit or sit down and just look at everywhere and see that, okay, Ghana is beautiful. No, they are coming to make profit. They are coming to make gain. They are coming to make profit. They are coming to do business. So we too, we for do business with them. As people are coming to do business, we too for do business. So everybody for benefit. Everybody for what? For benefit. So guys, as I heard this news, I say, I have to bring it to my gist partners. For the way, my gist partners have to hear this gist as it is hot. So if you have watched this point, I say thank you, thank you, thank you. And if you are on this channel, you have not yet subscribed. Me patcho, help me hit that subscribe button and hit notification bell. Let it do background. So that anytime there is news like this, anytime there is gist like this, nobody will tell you. You will hear with your ears. You will see with your eyes that news are bad. There is gist and there is news. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for your love and support. God bless you all and see you all in my next video. Bye.